This is a record that I've wanted to make for a while. To be working so creatively and passionately is what I've always wanted to do. It's really had to be done in a way that you capture the intensity of the song and the town and the experience that you have when you go there. It's amazing. I mean, what a town. Travel my way, take the highway. This record is very true to who I am and where I want to go for as far as I can see. Route 66. The Kings of Vegas has been really interesting to record because it's paying homage to the greats that have made the industry and the style what it is today, and that town what it is today. You know, from Nat King Cole, Sammy Davis, Frank Sinatra, Mel Torme, you've got incredible talents that have created this world that we revel in, I revel in.
Growing up with a lot of these beautiful songs, you know, they're timeless. They're really something so special. They're a present to the world. They're a real gift. Well, these records are all original pressings. So they're actually very, very, very dear to me. You've got Dean Martin, you know, some just incredible, incredible tunes from Dean. The King himself, Mr. Presley, which is his number ones, and one I play to death, actually. So I just love it. The chairman of the board, Mr. Frank Sinatra. What an incredible record. The song in the wee small hours of the morning. Just one of my all-time favorites, and I listen to it just as much as I listen to The King. And all these records, they really symbolize a great love for the era and for the style of music as well. And I don't think I realized how important they were to me until finally traveling to the hometown of where this music really made its mark on the world.
So I went to the US and I passed through some incredible old towns and along some amazing roads and finally hit Las Vegas.
Vegas was a playground for America, and it was where everyone went when they wanted to have a good time. And for a lot of the performers of that era, it was a place where they could really grow and evolve, I feel, because they had no strings attached to what they could do. There was no limits, you know. There was no one saying, we can't do this. You could do whatever you needed to, and I think that really inspired a generation of incredible music
and inspired me to create this record.
Harrison and I spoke about the album while we were on tour with the Disney concert, and you know, we've been talking about it for a while, and finally we found some time together and we decided to put this album together. It was a lot of, you know, toing and froing in terms of getting the repertoire, which is very important, and then figuring out how we're going to do it.
I think the thing that Chong brings to a record like this in particular is he brings experience and a passion for this kind of music. The feel that I want from this record, he helps me capture that.
She won't dish the dirt with the rest of those bras. That's why the lady is a tramp.
What Harrison's trying to do, which I'm helping achieve, is to pay homage to his favorite artists from that era, whether it's Mel Torme, Sammy Davis, Frank Sinatra, Tom Jones, Wayne Newton. You know, we're just trying to pay homage to those guys. So it's really a tribute to the Kings of Vegas.
That's why the lady, that is why the lady is a tramp.
just been such a beautiful process to record, to work with everyone, to explore new studios and new ways of recording. And, you know, from working with the band to creating what the record is now. We've had to record this record in such a way that you capture the vibe and the feel and the intensity of what you're performing, what you're actually talking about in the song, and you know where it came from, how it makes you feel, and really capture that with the band, with you as you know the artist, and really portray that on the record.
In making this record, I've tried to make it authentic to the Vegas period, the famous golden period, but still make it fresh, exciting, and new. Right from the outset, Harrison and I had decided we were going to do this with a live band. We've got a group of fantastic musicians who are good at that genre, the swing genre.
If you're going to be tackling this style, you need to have a live band because it just creates a vibe and the atmosphere that you need to record a great record.
Traveling to Vegas, incredible. The road alone is something special.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. And I've got you under my skin.
I have an affiliation with that song, especially driving to Vegas. The closer you get, the more excited you are, and you feel like I'm going to Vegas, and this is a place where I belong. You know, I feel it, you know, in my bones. And the places you pass along the way, like the Joshua Tree, you know, you're going through incredible towns like Barstow, San Bernardino, you know, Roy's Motel on Route 66, and it was just a blast to go there. You know, you see the impact that it would have had on the songwriters and the style of the song too. Don't you know, little fool? The heat driving to Vegas was something else. It was so hot but amazing because, you know, you're driving in this 1957 Ford Thunderbird. What a woman. To have such a beautiful car on such a remarkable trip, it really made it all that more special because, you know, you felt like you were in the 1950s. You know, you felt like you were back and you were driving with Frank and you were driving with Presley and you had them in the car and you were going to Vegas and you're going to do a show and it's going to be in lights. And that's the thing that gets me. It's a journey that I'll never forget.
Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Why not use your mentality? Step up, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. Because I've got you under my skin. And I love you under my skin.
Palm Springs was such a blast. To be in a town with so much history was awesome. I had so much fun driving around in this little buggy that I saw on the side of the road, and I said, that would be fun to drive that. And then I ended up just, you know, grabbing it and sort of driving it around. There was a lot of mucking around in Palm Springs, you know, really to get the essence of life in this great town.
Put your head on my shoulder. Hold me in your arms, baby.
There were certain moments during my travels to Vegas that really hit a nerve, you know, that really were special to me. Like, the whole trip was very special, but there were certain points that really stuck with me throughout the trip, and I thought, I'll never forget this. One of those was being at Frank Sinatra's house and actually experiencing the majesty of a man that had helped define an era and a style of music. And to have a real look into his life and how he lived and the music and the time that he lived in is pretty remarkable and extremely special. Being at the Sinatra house and performing a song like Put Your Head on My Shoulder was really special, you know, because you see the ultimate love that is in that house for the family, but not only for them, but for the music. And to actually, you know, see the original record player that Capitol gave to Frank, it's still there in the house. And to actually put a record there and press play and experience what he would have done was just, can't really put it into words, you know? And that's why I felt it was so important to actually show everyone this moment, because it was remarkable for me, and I hope it's remarkable for everyone else as well.
Tell me that you love me too.
Put Your Head on My Shoulder is a remarkable song. It really encompasses the romance between the artists and I think their love of Vegas or their love of a woman. And it's really, it's quite a crucial song to the album. It really ties in, you know, a lot of the love that you can feel throughout the album. Picking the 12 artists for this record was really hard. I started with a list of 300 songs and probably 45 artists, and it took me 6 months just to nail down the exact 10 songs that I wanted on this album and work out, you know, were they the right ones? Were these the ones that I affiliated with the most? You have to have an emotional response to every song, or else it's just not going to be the song that you want it to be. When you record a song, I think you have to really understand what the song's about, because every song is a story, and it's that element of telling the audience exactly how you're feeling and what you're doing and what kind of experiences you're going through. And a lot of them, I think, you can take at face value, but I think it's important to have your own spin, you know, your own life experience and your own hurt and your own love and your own happy moments and experiences within those songs. You know, you have to be performing them from a place that only sort of you really know. I want them to be real. For everyone that hears this record, I want them to go, oh, it's like this is the first time I've heard this song. The first time that I ever went to Vegas, it was an amazing trip. I spent a lot of time walking around through the strip, through downtown, heading to bars, you know, and experiencing the feel of a 4 a.m. piano bar. You know, when you're there and there's a piano tucked in the corner, and it's a feeling of, I guess, romanticism, but also with where you are. Go Dutch Street, you were sweet, Danke Shane, darling, Danke Shane. Save those lies, darling, don't explain. Coming home,
a couple of
I'm coming home, baby, now.
A song, man. Come on and give yourself
coming home. when I first put the album together, the first song that came to mind, I think, was Coming Home Baby. You know, I think that was at the forefront of my mind. Such a blast to perform, especially, you know, when you come in for the first time and it's like, do-do-do, coming home, baby, now. I'm coming home now, right away. And that moment when you first sing that, those first few lines, you just immersed in it straight away.
I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm coming home now, right away.
And, you know, you can't escape it. You can't lie about it. It's the feeling of passion and excitement in those songs, and it just drives me.
Coming home, baby, now.
You know I'm counting every day.
I'm coming home now, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm coming home, you're hearing what I said.
That you're coming home.
And I never will go away. I'm coming home.
It really spurred me to have quite the diverse range of songs that you find on the record, you know, and I think it's important to touch on lighter kinds of songs as well, you know, in this record, because Vegas was not just, you know, glitz and glam all the time. It really was a difficult time in that 1940s to 1970s kind of era. You know, to have those key elements on the record, you know, where you see lighter shades of this town that's just created such magical, timeless moments for people around the world, and huge songs that have created such a buzz that people play them over and over and over again, and that's pretty amazing. Creating this record has been such a joy, because it's music that I've grown up with since I was very, very young. And I've touched on this in my last two records, but this time round, I think for me, this is such a joy and a passion for so many reasons.
This is a kind of music that I really love. You know, I grew up with Sinatra and Mel Tormé, Nat King Cole, whom I love dearly. So it's a no-brainer to do this record, and it's really what I love to do. And of course, to get a fresh take of the music with Harrison's vocal is a very exciting thing to do. No one writes music like this anymore. It doesn't mean that there's no good music now, it's all great music, but I just am so fond of the era of, you know, swinging band, double bass, you know, kind of really nice guitar and brass, you know, what's there not to like?
I guess in the spirit of originality, it's more a record that is stripped back but still pays the respect to the music and the artists and the town that helped create such a whirlwind of excitement. And it's really an opportunity to give it my swing, you know, if you'll pardon the pun.
Traveling to Vegas is just the start. You know, I cannot wait to perform this live right around the country and indeed the world, and carry that incredible mantle of greatness from that era into, you know, into today and into the future. Welcome to the Kings of Vegas.
never know how much I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever when you kiss me, a fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, a fever all through the night. Oh, 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 oh. Sun lights up the daytime, moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm gonna treat you right.